News revelations on the Mandela effect. I want to share my experience with the world regarding the so-called Mandela effect. Hello people, my name is Fuad Rahman. I'm a journalist and author from Cape Town in South Africa. It is here where Nelson Mandela hails from. I met and shook hands with the great man, a world icon, soon after he was released. But little did I realize the effect in which he would propel the world into the parallel universe and Mandela effect syndrome. I'm writing a book on the Mandela effect, which would take some time. But I decided to disclose some of my findings. I hope you will find my contribution as informative. You can email me, and remember to please press like as it's helpful. Nelson Mandela was moved from his lifelong incarceration on Robben Island, somewhat 20 kilometers from the city of Cape Town, almost immediately and placed in a jail in Toke, a suburb of Cape Town. Coincidentally, I stayed out of university classes that day and accompanied my father, who worked as a removal truck driver, and who actually delivered a fridge to a warden of the Toke jail where Nelson Mandela was moved to. I said aloud, "Nelson Mandela is jailed here in Toke." The warder then introduced himself as James Gregory and told me, "I'm Nelson Mandela's jailer since the Rovana trial, where Mandela was sentenced to jail for life in 1962. What the warden further divulged puzzled me greatly. He said there was a secret about Mandela, but can't tell me. I didn't know what he meant. But it soon surfaced Nelson Mandela died on Robben Island and that the real Mandela was replaced by an imposter. So they claim and saying went, because some people had told me they could remember Mandela had died. Nevertheless, it was only years later that everything became clear and started to make sense with the emergence of the Mandela effect syndrome of seemingly false memories of people remembering occurrences but which appear to have never happened. In contrast, I can remember during the 1980s I was also imprisoned and driven from a Cape Town jail more than 1,000 kilometers to a remote small town prison in a small town called Brits in Pretoria. I was an anti-apartheid student activist at high school and university and jailed. And belonged to the same liberation movements of Nelson Mandela, the African National Congress, ANC, and also to the Pan-African Liberation. I clearly remember during the early dark morning, well before dawn, the two security policemen suddenly jerked the vehicle to a halt on the solitary road, uncuffed me and consequently, pulled their magnums on me. Nevertheless, the next moment I was strangely at the back in the car, being driven on the solitary road in the crew. In fact, one of the apartheid policemen looked cruelly at me through the driver's mirror and asked me the reason for having fought against them in Angola. I didn't answer him, but instead sang a freedom song. The security policeman then lit two cigarettes and turned around and handed me one of the Benson and Hedges mild smokes. When I asked them why they wanted to shoot me down like a dog, one of them looked at me very puzzled and answered, "What are you talking about?" But he added, "Don't give us ideas, we might just do it and shoot you." I was confused and shrugged it off as their denial of my close-to-death encounter. I never spoke to anyone about it. I thought perhaps I was dreaming. Also, I do clearly remember seeing on telly that Walt Disney's cartoon episode was spelt Looney Tunes, with Tunes spelt with a double O. I've a very good memory which never failed me. At university I could glance just once through the texts and I could remember almost 100%. Another mishap regarding the so-called Mandela effect was the branchlets in the teeth of Jaws and his girl at the end of the James Bond movie, Moonraker. I was a youngster at the time and my father recorded all the James Bond movies from TV. I was obsessed with 007 as a youngster and would watch the 007 movies over and over, including Moonraker. I do, undoubtedly recall Jaws' girlfriend also had braces on her teeth. Now it shows Jaws' girlfriend doesn't have branchlets on her front teeth. I can therefore deduce, history and our reality were altered. But it was too unbelievable to say the least. What makes sense now is the hypothesis and theory of parallel universes inside an infinite multiverse. The parallel universe slip could have come about through the dastardly scientific experiments concerning the split of particles at CERN in Switzerland. On the flip side, The South African apartheid government could have had a hand in the time slip, because had Nelson Mandela died in prison, there would have been an immediate violent revolution in the country. I met one of my captor by name of Adjutant Lieutenant Steenkamp in 1995 after the demise of apartheid in the streets of the city of Cape Town, who also divulged there was a strictly guarded secret concerning Nelson Mandela. I appealed to him to tell me, but he declined, saying I'm a journalist and that the Mandela best be kept secret, because it would evoke the collapse of the South African government. Popular Mechanics wrote their surprise the Mandela effect is still popular since Fiona Broom first made her observation public in 2009. Fiona Broom launched a website about her observance. Broom first encountered mass the parallel false memory syndrome when she first spoke with several people about remembering Nelson Mandela's death on the Robben Island political prison near Cape Town, during the early 1980s. However, in reality Nelson Mandela didn't die during the 1980s, but instead was released in 1990 and became president of South Africa 4 years later. He died in 2013. Fiona says on her website she was shocked to discover others remembered news coverage of Mandela's death in jail and his window, Winnie Mandela's tearful speech. Broom further says she was completely shocked that thousands could remember exact similar funeral of Mandela, whilst it never occurred. Consequently, Fiona discovered several other similar false memories and launched her website on which she further delved into what she termed the Mandela effect and other incidents like it. The Mandela effect indicates an occurrence in which a mass of people remember an event occurring whilst it did not.